one of my favorite groups, ladies and gentlemen. None other than the Dramatics. For those of you out there who don't know, we're going to get an introduction, and we're going to start with this gentleman right here.
Ron Banks, first tenor lead.
All right.
Willie Ford, bass. Some occasionally lead.
All right.
Craig Jones, second tenor baritone and lead.
Lenny Mays, second tenor baritone and lead.
So that means you all lead.
Sometimes.
No followers in this group. How do you do that, okay? You got four guys up here, four different heads. I want to be the boss.
Actually, everybody's greedy, you know. We just work it out that way.
Yeah.
Really?
No.
No, really, you just learn to respect within the structure of the four of us. There's each individual that has this special talent. So in a particular situation, you just learn to kind of deal with whoever's most qualified to handle that particular part of the business.
Okay. Now, let me just say this because I wasn't really, I won't say shocked, but I did not know. Mm. I saw the picture and I saw four guys on the cover. You know, I'm going to ask a question like this. The group has always had five members.
Exactly.
Let's talk about the slim lining of the group to four members.
Exactly. Well, we're down to four members right now. And I just like to say this personally to everybody that the door will always be open for Squirrel. That's our little buddy. He's been with us 16 years. And right now, he's just really dealing with it mentally as far as whether or not he wants to continue musically right now.
So I take it then that it's his own decision?
Right. Well, he's in school right now.
He's working in school right now. So, but like I said, the bottom line to that part is really the door will be open to Squirrel, and hopefully he'll return, you know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how many years has it actually been now? I don't know if you guys do your annual anniversary and tell exactly how many years, but the group is a living legend. You've been around Detroit, and you've been putting out hit records after hit records for years.
Definitely. The group has been together 16 years. Ron, Larry Demps, the two original members from the 16-year aspect. Mm-hmm. Myself, Lenny Mays, and Craig, we came on a little late in the game. I've been with them 13. Lenny's been 9 years.
Nine?
Craig,
right.
Been with us a year.
Yeah.
One complete year.
All right.
You don't even feel little, too.
All right, Craig. Got a lot of interesting. You know, we got a lot of interesting things coming up, man.
We'd like to
really talk to everybody, let everybody know. December the 15th, we'll be having the fourth annual Shoes for Children game, which features all the different celebrities against, like, the radio announcers, as well as the Motown Varsity Squad. We got Tommy Hearns in the game this year, him with Kenty.
Where's the game going to be this year?
It's going to be at Highland Park High School, which is like one block north of Sears in Highland Park.
Right. That's the new one.
Yeah, the new high school. Brand it's new. A very pretty facility, very well put together, and we'll have a lot of fun this year.
Right. What time, December 15th, what time?
At 7 o'clock, December the 15th, Monday night. It's going to be a shoot.
Hey, come on out and see them.
That's right. You can see all the jocks fall on the floor. This is the game they usually threaten us and tell us they won't play the records.
If you win, right.
But it's all for a very worthy cause, and every year you give away so many pairs of shoes.
Definitely. We've been given like 5,000 pairs of shoes. You know, we've been fortunate enough to give away that many over the years in the past. And really the bottom line, to see a child receive a pair of shoes to help him, like, go to school and do things that's necessary for a child to do, is nothing like to see that, you know, to see that child come up and say, like, I got a pair of those shoes.
Right on.
You know, so if you get a chance, we're inviting everybody out. That's at Highland Park, December the 15th at 7 o'clock, and we're going to work on you, Nat.
All right. What else is happening, of course, with this hot album?
We go from there to New Orleans. We'll be in New Orleans for 3 days, and then we go from there to Chicago for two at the theater called the Mule Run Theater. And, of course, as you know, and if you don't know, we're opening at the 20 Grand.
Huh?
December 26th through the 28th.
Did they hear you?
Yeah.
Did they hear you?
December 26th.
Well, you better tell them again.
December 26th through the 28th. The 20 grand. The new 20 grand.
Have mercy. We'll be looking forward to seeing you and guys over there.
Right.
That's right. You guys have a lot to talk about. It's been a long time since we talked, you know.
Sure.
And we got the poster up, and I've got to say, like I said, the album has continually shocked me. The tune that you just did,
right.
Red Day,
right.
Really like that.
Thank you very much, Nat. A little transition for us, you know, to deal with some up-tempo music. I would like to thank everybody so far for the support that we've been given as well. This is probably the hottest album that the Dramatics have had within the last three. And things are looking up. And the new single, which we're about to do here today, now for you.
Okay.
Entitled Detroit. And for all of you, you're the best thing in our lives.
All right. What about it for the Dramatics, ladies and gentlemen?